guys, Logan Vallis here, and today I am joined by a very special guest for this episode, for this review, my dog, Charlie. He will be joining me to review the film Alpha, since this is a movie about a wolf, or at least a dog. And this film is about a man being separated from his tribe, and then soon encounters a pack of wolves, and one of the wolves then gets separated by the pack. And then both of them had to, like, make a bond together in order to try to survive the upcoming seasons that are coming to them. I was looking forward to this movie simply because it's a movie that's about a man and a wolf bonding together, which started the whole domestication of dogs, of the dog, back then. And it's the reason why we have dogs like Charlie to this very day. And I will say that after watching this movie, it's okay. It's relatively decent, I will say. Now, there are issues that I have with Alpha that I thought could have been done better. And I will get into those issues, but first, I want to talk about some positives. Okay, he's trying to lay down. Because I guess he's getting tired of standing. But anyway, the positives. The visuals look phenomenal, and the cinematography looks phenomenal as well. I mean, the scenery with the landscapes and just everything else about it. The movie has many beautiful shots of the landscapes and everything else that the cinematography. Fantastic. I could not praise the visuals, the cinematography, and the scenery of all the landscapes that this movie shows, with many shots of the landscapes. I just can't praise them enough. They are worthy of being praised. And another positive that I have for this movie is the chemistry that the young man and a wolf have shared and bonded with throughout the second half of the film. It's very good. I feel like when they first started meeting each other, you really get the sense that the wolf is about to kill him, despite being stabbed by the young man. But then when the young man provides the wolf some food and water, the wolf suddenly became man's best friend somehow throughout the second half. It might seem implausible for some people, especially those who studied wolves or who knows much about wolves and how they behave and how they do things, or just stuff like that in general, that just the list goes on. It might seem implausible for some. However, I don't have very much problems with it. The performances, especially the young man's performance in general, was very good. And the wolf was very good. It looks very cool. Some of the shots, though, where the young man was carrying a wolf, it seemed like it didn't look like an actual wolf. It looked like something else. And then there were certain CGI shots of the wolf that kind of looked noticeable, I will say. But there were also many CGI shots that actually looked pretty damn good. Especially that one shot that was actually shown in the trailer, where the wolf was trying to get the young man from underneath a lake of ice. And just that was an awesome shot in and of itself. That was a badass shot. Now, with the negatives that I have for this film, the third act was really underwhelming, and it also was very choppy. There were certain points where the third act ends, and you thought it was going to end, and then it goes for more. And it also goes from one place within 5 minutes or less, and then goes to another place again, with 5 minutes again. The story for this movie is pretty flat. It's nothing more than just a story about a man being separated from his tribe, having to share a bond with a wolf that is also separated from its pack, and they have to work together in order to be, not be enemies to each other and not trying to kill each other, and then become friends. I felt like the story didn't have much else to it that is interesting, or at least to me it did. It just has nothing much to it. I feel like something else could have been added to the story that would have added more drama, which there is drama in this, but I feel like there's more to it that could have been put within this movie that could have made this film much better. But outside of that, outside of all the negatives that I could just mention, but it'll take me a much longer, just basically the story seemed pretty basic and fell flat outside of what it is. And just the third act alone felt really choppy and very underwhelming. As well as the characters, none of them were that memorable. They were very forgettable, save for the young lead. He's very good, as well as the wolf. The wolf is the best part in the entire film. As well as the visuals, the cinematography, and just everything else I mentioned that are positives. They're very fantastic. I'm going to give Alpha a silver medal of honor. So anyway, guys, that is my review for Alpha. I want to thank my dog Charlie for joining me in this review. It's a lot of fun. I haven't had Charlie be in my videos very much, but like I said earlier in this review, I'm very happy. I'm very blessed to have, man's best friend joining in this review. But anyway, guys, like I said, this is my review for Alpha, featuring a very special guest, my dog Charlie. Do you like Alpha, Charlie? Do you like the movie? He's just waiting to get out of my room so that he could spend time with my family. But that's about it. Anyway, guys, that's it. If you guys enjoyed my review, please click the like button, and if you have already saw Alpha in theaters, comment below and let me know what you think of it. If you enjoy what you've seen here and you want to see future videos from me, please press up there to subscribe and turn on the notification bell, and I will see you guys in the next video. Have a great week, Battle Squad, and as always, fight the good fight.